manufacturer of corn and dairy products. It was first operated in the year 1963, and it became the first milk company to be listed on the stock exchanges. And we also provide many types of products to consumers. These are the products of Dutch Lady. Dutch Lady is at the maturity stage on the product life cycle because it has the better sales in Malaysia, and also it is very stable. These are the BCG metrics. Star is for chocolate flavor and low fat milk. Question mark is strawberry flavor. Cash cow is full flavor, and dogs is coffee flavor. Salt analysis. Their strength is, everyone know Dutch Lady, right? So they have high brand loyalty, trustworthy brand, and they include HACCP and HALA standards, and they also provide quality products. Weakness is they have some poor of goods and services, lack of product awareness, and lack of experience and knowledge in UHT milk. Opportunity, they manage better in their product line expansion, and also they related to milk products such as butter, milk, coffee, chocolates, and cheese. Their strength is they face some strong competitors like Nestle or Nestle, Marigold. Sometimes consumers may be changing their taste, implementation of GST, and increase in raw materials. Tester analysis for political, the most important one is the tax policies such as GST 6%, economy, high inflation rate, economic growth, social, customer characteristics such as ethical interest, and so on. Technology, Dutch Lady use machine to produce their huge bulk of milk products in better and higher quantities, and also the environment promoting with environmental friendly in manufacturing and operational policies in all its function. Then the lager is the certification of HALA. And soft metrics, Dutch Lady use market penetration to promote their products. They set the low price of the product, and also they use psychology pricing with better deals and discount with to customers. Like how they sales with the amount is like the end of the amount is 99 or 29. They use odd pricing and multiple pricing. These are the example of Tesco online stores. And also they also keep innovate new products and flavor, and also keep changing the new packaging, like how they change it to the bottle one to easy to carry and more convenient. And the yogurt one, they change like calcium packaging. And the market development, since Dutch Lady milk is halal, so everyone can drink it, and it is suitable for any group of ages. It is a chance to develop to other countries with same product to different people. It is a mission, competitive advantage, and objective. For Porter's January strategy, Dutch Lady use differentiation strategy. Dutch Lady can easily differentiate their products with packaging like what I showed just now. And Dutch Lady Pure Farm has improved their packaging with handicap technology. It's what it showed. It is more easier to open, and the logo is attractive. For market segmentation, Dutch Lady target family, adults, and children. Demographic part, for Dutch Lady, they target age group of 7 to 59 years old, because since everyone can drink the milk, and suitable to every level of income from low to middle to high, as these products are not expensive and affordable by everyone. For behavior, it provides many different flavor of milk. Some of the Dutch Lady product, they created some cartoon image on their products to attract children. Psychology, they use psychology pricing. For positioning, focus on eco-friendly packaging, and they provide less sugar to more health conscious. Marketing mix, Dutch Lady used product line extension that supplies the product to different brand names such as Dutch Lady, Frisolac, Friso, Ethico, and Joy. They are under Dutch Lady brand. For price, like what I say, they use psychological pricing. They sometimes also come with the value pack. Dutch Lady also fish cheap price to their consumer. This is how Dutch Lady do their promotion. They mostly use free gifts and prizes to attract customers. Like how they cooperate with 7-Eleven, with 1 ringgit Malaysia you can buy the pure farm milk. It's only limit in 3 days. And they also do promotion on their social media, such as Facebook. They also do show campaigns and talk to increase awareness of Dutch Lady and also information about it. Distribution. Dutch Lady use intensive distribution. This type of distribution is convenience for customers and the price is kept low, so everyone can go to the store easily to find the products. For implementation, this is the timeline for the promotion, and it's from June 2017 to December 2017. This is a budget plan. The reason why I choose TV8 as the advertisement show because TV8 is the local channel that everyone can watch it for free, not like Astro need to charge or pay month by month. So the Star Newspaper, I will advertise it on every Sunday. So for contingency plan, like we can cooperate with running or marathon events, hire promoter in supermarket to know more our products, and also cooperate with another company like how Coca-Cola with McDonald's.
Okay, right. So now some questions. Now you have displayed cartoon characters on the milk earlier. So I'd like to ask, do you think this is an ethical method of marketing the products?
Yeah.
Justified?
Yeah, because children nowadays, they don't like to drink milk because milk contains nutrition. So some of the children, if they see these cartoon characters, they will beg their parents to buy for it.
So that's why, do you think it's ethical?
Yeah.
Yes. Because now you are forcing the parents to buy because the children are attracted to the cartoon characters, so they are going to put pressure to the parents. So do you think this is a correct way to market your product? Okay, next question, what is your weakness? Okay, look at the weakness. Look at the second and the third point. Lack of product awareness. We checked out, Dutch Lady is a very strong brand, and lack of experience and knowledge in UHT.
Yeah.
Which is also, I feel, it is a bit weird because they are many years in the market. So can you explain this?
Because everyone think of Dutch Lady, they only think for the milk, but they ignore the UHT. So some of the people doesn't know about the information of UHT milk. And they less active at social media.
But if you say people means customers which are external, it's a threat, this is internal. Who are you referring to? You're referring to customers.
Yeah.
Customers are not internal. Weakness will be internal problems, internal within the organization. So can you clarify that? Okay, you go to your customers, target audience. Then you show me your customer target audience by age. Then you see here 7 to 59. What happened to above 60? Why you have put 7 to 59?
These are the standard age that.
That's why I like to ask, what happened to those above 60? Is this still function? Will they still be your target audience? Any reason to justify why 59? Why it stops at 59?
Because
the nutrition they provide is for 59. So you're 60 years old, you're not doing well.